are again. Here we go in the 7-Wire Rewind Show. We're going to bring you the Florida Derby today and the incredible, one and only undefeated Big Brown. Lettie, a lot of people didn't think he could overcome his post position draw, including Randy Moss, who chose the incredibly poorly run Elysium Field. But I believe that Big Brown looked really good that day. He was very...
He did an angle coming out of the gates. Everybody here is going to notice where he just shoots. He runs. What do you think? I don't know, 1/16 of a mile more than all the other horses in the race, or that, you know, any horse on the inside, and just comes across the whole track at a direct
angle. Really nice. Very traditional.
Makes the lead by the turn almost. Yeah. And so, yeah, I mean, you just can't knock Big Brown at all. And
well, you can't knock him, but we'll knock him in a minute. But let's take a look at the race, and then we'll get back to you on that.
Kent DeSormo has got to break well on Big Brown. Look for Ibar Cole on Elysium Fields to ease back about 4 or 5 lengths off the lead.
Inside, outside. That's what you watch leading.
Bookends.
There he is, Big Brown. And let's meet the track announcer who is going to call this critical Kentucky Derby prep. Larry Colmes will have the call. The 57th running of the $1 million Florida Derby. Hello, Larry.
Big Brown getting set to go into the starting gate here. The horses are loaded, just about ready for the start of the 57th running of the Grade 1 Florida Derby. Big Brown at 3-2 on the tote board. Just balked a little bit, but they've got him in line. Closing up the gate. We're set for the start. They're off in the Florida Derby. And Fierce Wind fires fast from the inside. Smooth Air is right alongside, and Big Brown's going to be wide into that turn, but he's up with the pace setters, and Nisley's Crunch is up there too. So it's Big Brown, Nisley's Crunch in a tight spot there, and Fierce Wind down on the inside. Face the Cat is in fourth. He's racing 2.5 lengths off the lead. Elysium Fields is fifth early. He's just outside of them, and then to the inside comes Smooth Air. Hay Burn is racing about 7 off the lead. Right to the inside comes Datara. Break of another 2 to Cool Gator. Then BB Frank to the outside. Majestic Warrior and the Peruvian Tom Cito is last. A fast pace here. 22-3 the first quarter, and Big Brown has made the lead. Big Brown and Kent DeSormo in front by a length. Nisley's Crunch, his closest pursuer, second. And then it's Face the Cat in third. Elysium Fields is fourth on the outside. He's 5 lengths off the lead. Smooth Air just went by Fierce Wind. He's under a ride after a 45.4 half mile. And then it's a length and a half back to Hay Burn looking to get going. Datara is next. Cool Gator to the outside. Majestic Warrior's got work to do. Tom Cito and BB Frank around the far turn, 3/4 and 1/10 flat. And Big Brown has a 2.5 length lead here over Nisley's Crunch. Then Smooth Air. Hay Burn is fourth. He's down on the inside as they come to the top of the stretch in the Florida Derby. And Kent DeSormo and Big Brown have the lead. They're in front by 4 lengths at the 8th pole. And they're widening here from Smooth Air, who's been left behind. And Big Brown has done it. Big Brown, undefeated, on his way to Louisville as he wins the Florida Derby. Smooth Air in second.
Can you knock Big Brown?
Well, the Kentucky Derby will be his 4th race, so I don't know what to say about that. He proved himself. He's proven with a big field. But then again, look, the Florida horses to me this year are absolutely not impressive. The Fountain of Youth is a joke to me. What they did with the Holy Bull is ridiculous, and I don't understand why they put that race there. The Florida races just seem to be the weakest of everywhere, and so to me, for Big Brown to dominate them, he better have dominated those horses, because to me, I feel like the Lane's End was stronger than the Florida Derby. So that is my big knock on him. But then again, he popped out of that gate like a man. He busted out of there, and I think the biggest myth, we've said it before, I've said it, is that Big Brown is just a speed horse. He is not just a speed horse. He looks to have a diverse style. He obviously will take the lead if he needs it, but he can sit back there as he did in that allowance race for a little bit and let the other horses do a little bit of the dirty work. He has got a little dirt in his face before, so I feel like Big Brown is tough. I mean, he's obviously going to be hard to beat.
One of the few horses in this year's Derby with multiple triple-digit buyers going into the race. And I think despite the fact that perhaps the Florida fields haven't been that strong, Smooth Air wasn't a bad horse.
No,
you know, there's
fine.
A couple other semi-decent horses in this race. And I think, you know, it's just a general the crop is a little bit weaker this year, then it's hard to follow last year. I mean, seriously. Who doesn't love thoroughbred racing when you've got street sense, hearts on any given Saturday, and of course...
Curlin! But speaking of Curlin, how about Curlin? How about coming into the Derby undefeated last year and him not being able to get it done? So I know the crop was tougher last year, but that is just something that another obstacle have to overcome.
So ran a really game third.
Yep. But then again, I just say Big Brown. You probably got to go for him, but...
Otherwise, we wouldn't be wearing the shirt. So, first Saturday in May, win that money, honey.